Hello students, how are you? What's going on nowadays?
What? Three things you are doing.
Playing. Only one thing it means.
Then what is about the studies?
No studies.
Why?
No college, no school, no tuition, no studies.
Then what is about the examination?
Which you have to appear for at the end of the academic year. Then you have to study. Here I am with the solution of your this problem. Welcome to my class. I am Professor Swati. I will teach you the mathematics and probably if time helps the science of 10th and 12th standard. So today I am going to start mathematics for 12th standard. So for 12th standard I am going to use these books. This is for paper 1. You must have these books because these are the textbooks recommended by the Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary School. So this is for paper 1 and this is for paper 2. Okay? So I will give you the solution for each and every sum of each and every exercise of each and every chapter. Okay? So be happy. Here is your tuition is started now. Okay then, so without wasting much time, we will start our syllabus. So, firstly, I am going to start with a simple chapter, which is easiest of among all the chapters in the syllabus. Okay, and that is mathematics. You must know everything about the, means introductory matrix you know. That is definition, types of matrices, then the algebra of the matrices, all these things you have learnt in 11th standard. But maybe because of this lockdown and all this tension of corona, you have lost everything about the studies only. Other things you do not forget, but study you forget. Okay? So let us have a quick recap of this. Let us start from the definition. Matrix is an ordered rectangular array of numbers or functions in the bracket. So matrix always we write in a bracket like in the rectangular bracket. Let us start from the definition. Matrix is an ordered rectangular array of numbers or functions in the bracket. So matrix always we write in a bracket like in the rectangular bracket x is order of the matrix. Okay. So let us have our matrix A, B, C, D, F, G. So just we have seen in definition of the matrix, that matrix is an arrangement. So these are the elements are arranged in certain manner. Okay. So these are the horizontal lines. These are the horizontal lines in this way, and these are the vertical lines. So these horizontal lines are called as rows. If single is then row, and these vertical lines are called as columns. If single, then column. Okay. Now, depending upon the number of rows and number of columns, the order of the matrix we can find or we can write. So, how many rows are there? 2. How many columns are there? 3. So, what is the order of this matrix A? 2 by 3. How to read? 2 by 3. Okay. So, this is the
order of the matrix. Now this is always considered that first number represents number of rows and second number represents number of columns. Listen, if you are given coordinate of certain number, suppose this is given 4 columns. This is coordinate, this is a number and these are the coordinates. So it is considered, you know, everybody knows that 4 always represents abscissa, that is x coordinate, and 5 always represents ordinate, that is y coordinate. Means it is not necessary to tell every time that this is x coordinate, this is y coordinate. This is considered. So similarly here also, first number always says number of rows and second number always tells us the number of columns. Suppose you have given certain matrix of order 3 by 4. Then how many columns are there? 4. And how many rows are there? 3. Okay then? Understood? Let us go for the types of the matrices. So matrix is singular and matrices is plural noun matrix. Okay? So first is row matrix. So name itself suggests that if single row is there, how many rows are there? Only one. And how many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is a row matrix of order 1 by 4. The number of rows always 1 in row matrix. Okay? And number of columns are limited, or 2 or 3, whatever the number is. But in row matrix, the number of rows are 1. Okay? Second, column matrix. You must guess this. Means a matrix having single column. A matrix having single column is called as column matrix. In how many rows are here? If you want to find the order of this matrix, then 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many rows are there? 4. And how many columns are there? 1. Means what is the order of the matrix? 4 by 1. Means row matrix will always have 1 by something its order. This is row matrix. And column matrix will always have something or some number into 1 as the order. This is row matrix order and this is column matrix order. Okay? Let us go for the types of the matrices. So matrix is singular and matrices is plural noun of matrix. Okay? So first is row matrix. So name itself suggests that if single row is there, how many rows are there? Only 1. And how many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is a row matrix of order 1 by 4. The number of rows always 1 in row matrix. Okay? And number of columns are limited, or 2 or 3, whatever the number is. But in row matrix, the number of rows are 1. Okay? Second, column matrix. You must guess this. Means a matrix having single column. A matrix having single column is called as column matrix. In how many rows are here? If you want to find the order of this matrix, then 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many rows are there? 4. And how many columns are there? 1 only. Means what is the order of the matrix? 4 by 1. This row matrix will always have 1 by something its order. This is row matrix. And column matrix will always have something or some number into 1 as the order. This is row matrix order and this is column matrix order. Okay? Now next is square matrix. A matrix having
equal number of rows and columns.
Means A, B, C, D, F, G, I, J, K.
So how many rows are there?
Three.
And how many columns are there? Okay. So this is a matrix. This is called as square matrix. Why? Because number of rows and number of columns are same.
B 2 by 2.
So this is also a square matrix.
Or something C 1 by 1.
This is also a square matrix. Means any order having number of columns and number of rows same, then that is called as a square matrix. Equal number of rows and equal number of rows and columns. Okay, this is the square matrix. Now, depending upon the square matrix, there are so many types of matrices here. So, very first is diagonal matrix. So, diagonal matrix. Suppose this is a matrix, a square matrix. Diagonal matrix starts with a square matrix having, listen, now suppose this is a matrix E, F, G, I, J, K. This is a square matrix. Then there are two diagonals here. One is this and one is another. This is called as principal diagonal. Principal diagonal. Okay? And if only the numbers are there at the place of principal diagonal only, and other all the numbers are zero, this is called as a diagonal matrix. This is called as a diagonal matrix. Listen, means that is, what is the A now? If we write clearly and this is then A 0 0, 0 B 0, 0 0 0. Only diagonal elements are non-zero. Only diagonal elements are non-zero, other all the elements are zero. Okay, so this is a diagonal. This is a diagonal. And diagonal, even diagonal is only principal diagonal, not this diagonal. This diagonal not, okay? This principal diagonal only. If the principal diagonal elements are non-zero and other all the elements are zero, then that is called as a diagonal matrix. Now next is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix having all diagonal elements equal, having all diagonal elements equal. Okay, now next is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix having all diagonal elements equal, having all diagonal elements equal. Okay, now we know the diagonal matrix is a matrix having only elements at the place of principal diagonal, other all the elements are zero elements. So little bit improvement in diagonal matrix, will make it scalar matrix if all the diagonal elements are same. So A, you may have C, but what is the condition? All the diagonal elements are equal, and other than the diagonal, all are zero. So this is our scalar matrix. Okay. Now next is identity matrix. So here also little bit improvement. Okay. Now identity matrix is a scalar matrix. Is a scalar matrix having all the diagonal elements as unity. Diagonal element as unity means at the place of principal diagonal,
here there are only one and one, that is one element, that is one. So this is called an identity matrix. An identity matrix has specific representation, that is I. Identity matrix has specific representation by alphabet I. So I 3 by 3, if we say I 3 by 3 or I 3 or I 3, so that is identity matrix of order 3 by 3. I 2, that is identity matrix of order 2 by 2. Okay. I 1, that is only one element. Okay. This is your identity matrix. Now next is, next we will see the transpose of matrix. This is, next we will see the transpose of matrix. Okay, the transpose of matrix. So let us have one matrix A, B, E, F, I, J. Okay, so what is the order of this matrix? Number of rows 3, number of columns 2. Okay, so transpose of matrix means changing rows to column, and automatically column will change to row. That is, and transpose of matrix we will denote by A power P or A dash P. Okay, so what is the transpose of this matrix then? A transpose equals to A B. First row becomes first column. Second row E F becomes second column. Third row I J becomes third column. Okay, now how many rows are there? How many columns are there? How many rows are there? Two. How many columns are there? Three. So transpose of a matrix having order exactly opposite of original matrix. If this has 3 by 2, then transpose will have 2 by 3. If E1 has A by B, then the transpose of it will have B by A order. Okay? So this is the transpose of a matrix. Now depending upon the transpose of matrix, there are two types of matrix. Depending upon the transpose of matrix, there are two types. That is symmetric matrix. Okay? Suppose A transpose and A both are equal. A transpose and A both are equal, then that is called as symmetric matrix. Okay? Suppose if we take the example, that is 2, 3. Okay, and 3, 4. Suppose this is a matrix. Then what is its transpose? A transpose with 2, 3 become 2, 3. Okay, 3, 4 becomes 3, 4. Okay, the A and A transpose both are equal. Okay, therefore this A is called as symmetric matrix. And second, depending upon the transpose, second is skew symmetric matrix. See, suppose A transpose is minus A, negative A, then it is called as skew symmetric. Suppose A is like this, 1, sorry, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Okay, if this is the matrix, then what is the transpose of it? This transpose is 0, minus 1, 1, 0. And if you write, then we can say that minus of 0, minus 1, 1, 0. That is, this is nothing but A. So minus A. Okay? Now we will see triangular matrix. Now there are again two types of triangular matrix. One is upper triangular and second is lower triangular. So what is upper triangular, we will see. Suppose this is a matrix. So what is upper triangular matrix? Now we know that this is a principle. This is a principal diagonal. So above the principal diagonal, only there are non-zero number, and below the principal diagonal, all the elements are zero. Okay, this is called upper diagonal. With above the principal diagonal, all the elements, not all the elements are zero. Maybe two elements are zero or one element zero, but not all the elements. Okay. So what is upper triangular? Above the principal diagonal, all the elements are not all the elements are above the principal diagonal. Not all the elements are zero. At least one element should be non-zero. And below the principal diagonal, all the elements are zero. That is called the upper triangular. Now, what is the lower triangular? Suppose we say like this: A, B, C, D, F, G, I, J, K. Then exactly opposite. This is our principal diagonal. So, below the principal diagonal, below the principal diagonal, all the elements are not zero. Means maybe one element is zero, two elements zero, but three elements we don't want zero. Okay, this is in square matrix. So below the principal diagonal, all elements should not be zero. Not all the elements. And above the principal, we want all the elements are zero. So this is your upper triangular and this is lower triangular. And these are triangulars. Okay, this is upper, this is lower, and these are the triangular matrix. Okay, these are the triangular matrix. Now, again, depending upon the, now we know what is determinant. Okay, so we will first find determinant of matrix. We will find determinant. A, B, C, E, F, G, I, J, K. And determinant of matrix can be found only and only in case of square matrix. Only the square matrix will have determinant. Okay? If number of rows and number of columns are equal, then and then only we can find a determinant of that. Okay. So this is a matrix A. Then determinant of matrix is denoted by A in two parallel lines, and all the elements of A we have to write in two parallel lines. Okay. Now, the basic question always been asked. Okay. So what is the difference between the determinant and matrix? So, major difference is what? Matrix is just an element. Matrix is just an element. And determinant is a scalar, because you know, if we solve this, we know how to find, how to solve the determinant. If we solve this determinant, you will get a one, a number, a scalar. So determinant is a scalar and matrix is just a arrangement. This is the basic difference. But if we want to find the determinant of a matrix, then we have to just write all the elements of matrix like this in two parallel lines, and then we can solve it and we can find the value of this. Directly we cannot solve this. If the all the elements are in square like it, then we can't solve it. We have to take all the elements in two parallel lines, then it becomes determinant, and then we can solve it as is were. Okay. So depending upon this determinant of matrix, there are two types of matrices. There are two types of the matrices. One is singular matrix and another is non-singular matrix. Okay. So what is singular matrix? As we have seen how to find determinant, if we found determinant, it is zero. If the determinant of any matrix is zero, then it is called as a singular matrix. Okay, and if the determinant of any matrix is not zero, then it is called as the non-singular matrix. Okay, these are the types. Now last type we will see of matrix, that is zero matrix or null matrix. Zero or null matrix. Okay, matrix having all the elements zero. All the elements zero. Then no restrictions on order and nothing. Means A may be 0, 0, 0, 0. Or, and generally or mostly they denote zero matrix by O. Zero matrix by O. Okay? So, like this. There is no restriction for the zero matrix. It may be square or it may not be. Okay? Understood? Now, next is algebra of matrices. Algebra of matrices. Okay? So, we first is equality of matrix. Equality of first is equality of matrices. Two matrices are equal if and only their order is same and corresponding elements are equal. Okay? So, A equals to B if order of A is equal to order of B and corresponding elements are equal. That is, suppose this is a matrix A, B, C, D, and this is another matrix equal to X, Y, Z, W. Then we will say that A is nothing but X, B is nothing but Y, C is nothing but Z, and D is nothing but W. Okay? So, order of this matrix is also 2 by 2 and this matrix is also 2 by 2. Not necessary that for the equality of matrix, we need the square matrices. In any type of the matrix, means in any order, we will have the equal matrices. Okay? So, this is the equality of matrices. Now, next, addition subtraction, we will not go in detail because you know already. Because for the addition and subtraction also, we need the, if we want to add two matrices, then we should have those two matrices of same order. And corresponding element will get added or corresponding element will get subtracted. Now very, when students feel it difficult, that is multiplication, matrix multiplication. So first, multiplication will be right. Because there are also two multiplications. One, scalar multiplication. This is simple one. Okay, this is simple. This, if we multiply, suppose this is A. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then if we want to multiply by 2 to this matrix, then we will write 2A. Like this. 2 in bracket same. And what will be the answer? 4, 6, 12, 8, 10. So this is simple. Scalar multiplication is simple, no problem there. Just we have to multiply by that scalar to each element of the matrix. To each element of the matrix. Now next is, that is little bit difficult student feel, but not difficult actually. Matrix multiplication. So for matrix multiplication, we need one condition. If the number of columns of first matrix is equal to number of rows of second matrix, then the matrix multiplication of these two matrices is possible. Okay? Understood? Number of columns of first matrix should equal to number of rows of second matrix. Okay, number of rows of second matrix. Means suppose you have a matrix of order. You have a matrix of order 2 by 3. Suppose. Okay, this is a matrix. And another matrix you have like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 0. Then what is the order of this matrix? 3 by 3. So neither two numbers we need equal. Okay. Then the matrix is matrix multiplication is possible. Okay. So A B product A B is like this. A B is possible. Okay. Then this is just a condition. What? How to multiply? We discuss. So this is just the condition that we want number of columns of first matrix. Always say first matrix. Okay, it should equal to the number of matrix of second matrix. Okay, so this is the condition for the matrix. Means you have, suppose you have a matrix of order m by n, and if you have a matrix of order n by p, okay, then this n is equal. So this multiplication is possible, and the answer matrix will be AB, and order of that will be m. Okay, middle number should be equal, and these number, that is n numbers, will be the order of answer matrix. We will have some example because this is little bit hard for the students to understand. Okay. We will see the matrix multiplication. How to multiply the matrices? Okay. Now, this, suppose this is A 6 9 2 3. So, what is the order of this matrix? 2 by 3. This matrix. What is the order of this matrix? 2 by 3. So, number of columns of first matrix is equal to number of rows of second matrix. So, AB is possible. So, matrix multiplication AB is possible. How to multiply? Okay. Now, first row of first matrix will go in multiplication and addition in first column of second matrix. Then 6 into 2 plus 9 into 2. This is the first element of answer matrix. And answer matrix will have order 2 by 3. Means answer matrix we can see this matrix in 2. That's the answer matrix. This will be the answer matrix. Okay, 2 by 3. So this is first element. Now second, first row and second column. So 6 into 6 plus 9 into 5. And what is about the third number here? First row and third column. 6 into 1 plus 9 into 5. Okay? Now here multiplication. Now first row, we have all the elements of first row. Okay? Because first row we multiply to first column of second matrix, second column of second matrix, third column of second matrix. So row of first matrix is open row. Now row of second matrix of first matrix starts. Okay? So this is second row, first column. 2 into 2 plus 3 into 2. And 2 into 6 into 3 plus 3 into 5. 2 into 1 plus 3. To solve this, you will get the answer.
So this was the introduction for matrix, which you have learned in 11th standard. Now let us start the syllabus for the 12th standard. So first point in the syllabus of 12th standard is elementary transformation. Because the transformation is on elements of matrix, so it is called as elementary transformation. So if we have a matrix like this, A, B, C, E, F, G, then these are called as rows. So this is first row, so R1, this is second row, so R2. So we will denote this by R1, R2. This is first column, so we will denote this by C1. This is second column, so we will denote this by C2, and this is C3. So depending on this R1, R2, if R3 is there, then R3, C1, C2, C3, there are 6 operations. Actually, there are 3 operations, but similar operation on rows and similar operation of columns. So book is given. So in book it is given that there are 6 operations, but actually there are only 3 operations. Okay. So first, interchanging rows, or if we are dealing with columns, not rows and columns. I will explain that. Okay. So what is that? Suppose R1 will exchange to R2. Means at the place of R1, we will have R2. Means all the elements of R1 will go at the place of R2, and all the elements of R2 will go at the place of R1. Similarly, if we are dealing with column, then C2 exchange with C3. Means all the elements of C2 will go at the place of all the elements of C3, and all the elements of C3 will come at the place of C2. But this is not done, okay? That R1 will exchange with C3. No. Exchange of rows and column is not allowed. Only the exchange of rows and rows, or exchange of columns and columns only allowed. Okay? Understood this? So this is first. First means, here you can write R3 will go at R1. Means R3 and R1 you can exchange. Here maybe you exchange C1 and C2. You may exchange, okay? Interchange their places. So this is the first transformation. Second transformation is scalar multiplication to any row, or if we are dealing with column, then column. That is, R1 will become K×1. Means all the elements of R1 we have to multiply by K, or R2 is ½×1. R2 same, scalar multiplication, and here non-zero you can see. Third transformation is adding all the scalar multiples of elements of any row to any other row. Okay, that is, suppose R1 will change to R1 plus KR. Okay, what we are doing? We are multiplying here R2 by some scalar and adding this in it. Okay. So R1 plus KR, or you may say R3 will R3 plus minus 3 R2 is. Understood? So first is R1, second is R3. Similarly, if you are dealing with the columns, then C1 will change to C1 plus twice C, or C3 will change C3, C1, C3, C3, plus minus 5, C2. Understood? Only these 3 transformations we have to see. Now, let's come to exercise
2.0. This is first number. What is the question? Apply given transformation on given matrix. So very first is A 1 0 minus 1 3, and we have to operate R 1 and R 2, means interchanging R 1 and R 2. So A. So this is the equivalent sign. A equals to, we will not write, we will use equivalent. A equivalent to. So R 1 and R 2 we have to interchange. So minus 1 3, 1 0. Oh, done. This is now minus 1 3, that was R2 previously, now it is R1. This was 1 0, this was R1 previously, now it is R2. Okay, now B equivalent to, what is the transformation? We have to do operation only on R1, only on R1, so R2 remains as it is. So there is no change on R2. So R2 write as it is and do the operation on R1 only. Now R1 will change to R1 minus R2. So what is the first element of R1? 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2. Okay? Then minus 1 minus 5. Then 3 minus 4. So that is R1 minus R2. R1 minus R2. The transformation we have to do on corresponding element of that row. Okay? So R1 minus R2. That is B equivalent to minus 1, minus 6, minus 1, and no change in R2. So it is R2. So this is your second example. Now this is third example. A is given like this, and we have to operate on columns. And here it is B, and we have to operate on rows. So what is A equivalent to? Exchange C1 and C2. Means this is C1, this is C2. We have to do their exchange. Okay? And here, exchange of rows. Equivalent. Sign equivalent. So, R1 becomes R2. R2 becomes R2. So what is their question again? What do you observe? Then what do we observe? We observe that both the answer matrix matrices are equal. Nothing more than that. No? Fourth example. So this is given A matrix. We have to do the operation, its transformation to C2. Means we will write in solution C2 changes to 2C2. So A equivalent to. So C2 only we have to deal with. So there is no change on C1 and C3. So write down C1 and C3 as it is. First work we will do. That if you don't do anything, other columns or other rows, you have to write them as it is. Now C2 multiplied to is 4. Okay, now here also solution R1, there is a change on R1. So B becomes like this. So there is no change on R2, so write down R2 as. So minus 3, 0, minus 6. And again, what is the question after that? Find the addition of these two matrices. So this is a A matrix and this is B matrix. So their addition, we will write addition of them. That is A plus B equivalent. Now we know that if the order of two matrices is equal, then add the corresponding element. So what is the order of this matrix? 2 by 3. And order of this matrix also 2 by 3. Therefore addition is possible, and we have to add the corresponding elements. This 1 minus 3. Minus 4 minus 4 0, that is 4. Minus 1 minus 6, that is minus 7. Okay? 0 2 means 2. 2 4 6 and 3 5, that is answer is also of same order. Answer matrix will also same. So this was our fourth. Let us come
what is the conclusion. Then what is conclusion? The transformations are commutative. If we change the places of the transformations, answer will remain same. Now, seventh example. Now, given matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to convert this matrix into upper triangular matrix. Now, what is that? Suppose we will let, name it as A. Let A is 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to convert this into upper triangular. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4. What will be the upper triangular matrix? This is our principal diagonal. Above the principal diagonal, only non-zero number, this remains zero. Okay, so we have to convert this 2x2 matrix, 2x2 square matrix, into the upper triangular matrix. That means we have to bring here 0. Okay, so how will you bring here 3? With the help of R1, we have to change on R2. That is, there is no change of R1. Okay, we want change in, there is no change in R1. We want change of R2 only. So R2 will change. So how much we subtract from 3? So we will get 0 here. If we subtract 3 minus 3. Okay. But in this such operation is not allowed. Only 3 operations are allowed. We can exchange. We can multiply by scalar. Non-zero scalar. Non-zero scalar. This is important. Otherwise we can multiply by 0 and we will get 0 here. No, that is not allowed. Non-zero scalar. So first operation transformation we cannot use, second transformation we cannot use. So we have to multiply, it means R2 minus, this is 1 here. So it is very useful. This is 1 here. So if we multiply here 1 by 3, okay, means 3 minus 3 into 1, this side. Okay. So with the help of R1, we have to make this R2 this place 0. So understood this transformation? We want here 0 with the help of R1. With the help of R1. We cannot do first operation. There is no 0 anywhere, so we can exchange. No, it is not possible. So first transformation is useless. Second transformation, multiplication, non-zero scalar multiplication. So here with such a number is not present there. So we can multiply each and become 0 rather than 0. So only third option remains, that is R2 minus 3R. Now let us do this. So there is no change on R1, so 1, 2 as it is. R2, for this 0 only we are doing this operation. So 0 we have to write directly, because for that only we are doing this one. Then R2 here for this number 4 minus 3 R1, that is 2. So what is our answer matrix? Equivalent to 1, 2, 0, 4 minus 6, that is 1. Okay? So this is the upper triangular matrix we got from our question matrix. Understood? Now question number 8. We have given one matrix, this 1, minus 1, 2, 3. And we have to convert this matrix into I, means identity matrix. Now order of this matrix is 2 by 2. So identity matrix we have to bring in also of order 2, that is I2. So we have to convert this matrix in this way. So we will get here I2. So start here. Let's start. Let this matrix is A. So 1, minus 1, 2, 3. So what is identity I2? 1, 0, 0, 1. So already there is 1, so no problem. So make it 0 first. We have to do column by column. Whenever you will find the identity matrix, go column by column. Means first we have to bring first column. For identity matrix, you have to bring first column and then think of second column. Don't do like this, that this is 1 and bring here 0. No, because we are dealing with the row transformation. We are dealing with the row transformation, so we have to go column by column. Understood? All the examples further and now also we will solve the row transformations. So go by column by column.
So this is one already there. Here we have to bring zero, and after bringing here zero, we will bring here one, and then we will bring here one, and then here zero. Understood? We will go like this. Here we will bring for zero, then we will bring here one, and then we will bring here zero. Understood? Understood how to bring identity matrix? So let us bring this one. So what is first operation we have to do? We have to bring here zero. So R2 we have to change on. So R2, matlab what is, we want 2 minus 2. But such operation is not possible. So we will do 2 minus 2 into 1. Means R2 minus 2 into R1. Now A equivalent to, now only change on R1. Sorry, only change on R2. So write down R1 as it is. Okay? So this operation is for this element only. It is 3 from here. Now operate on this. R2 means 3 minus 2 R1. 3 minus 2 R1. Okay? 3 minus 2 R1. Okay? Now solve this. So what is A equivalent then? 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, 0. And what is here then? 3 minus minus plus 2 is 5. Okay? Now next we have to bring, now this column what we wanted? We wanted I2. 1 0 0 1. So we have got our first column. So think about the second column. In second column also, we have to first find the place where 1, where we want 1. Here we want, don't think about this 0, think about this 1. So here we want 1. So 3 operation only we have. We can exchange any row to other row. We can multiply by non-scalar, non-zero scalar. That is R1 changes to, suppose K into R1. And third we have just done. R1 changes to R1 plus something into any other column. So only 3 any other row. So only 3 transformation we have. So for this particular we will use this second transformation. So we will multiply. So R2 will change to 1 by 5 R. Like this would be only. Okay? R2 will change to 1 by, means scalar multiple of that. So A equivalent to 1. No need to do anything on R1. So R1 will add it. This is, if we multiply by 0 to 1 by 5, no change will be there. And here 1 by 5 into 5 is 1. Is it easy? Understood? Okay. The last, we want to bring here 0. We want to bring here 0. So with the help of these only, we have to bring there 0. So if we add them, we will get here 0. Means on R1 only we have to change that R1 plus R. R1 will change R1 plus R. Means this is third number transformation. This is number 3 transformation. So A equivalent to, oh, no need to do anything on R2. So R2 write down as it is. Here, R1 plus R2 means addition of these 2, no change on 1. R1 plus R2, addition of these 2. In this way, this is nothing but your identity matrix of order. Now come to 9th, that is last example of this exercise. The matrix is given this. I have given the name as A. Let A be the 1 minus 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, and 3, 2, 4, and we have to convert this matrix into upper triangular matrix. Upper triangular matrix means above the diagonal matrix, above this diagonal, all elements should not be 0. But below the diagonal, all elements we want 0. Means here we have to bring 0, here we have to bring 0, and here we have to bring 0. With the help of, we will do here 0 and here with the help of this R1. So here we want 0, means 2 minus 2 it will become 0, and here 3 minus 3 equal it becomes 0, means we have to offset like this. So, R2 changes to R2 minus 2 into R2, because directly we cannot say 2 minus 2. This is not allowed. This third type of transformation we have to use. We cannot get 0 by exchanging, because nowhere there is 0. We cannot multiply by 0 number. It is because in second transformation, first transformation is interchanging. Second is non-scalar multiplication. It means we cannot bring here 0 by multiplying 0. So this is only the option we throw. So R2 changes to R2 minus 2R2. At the same time, we can do the operation of R3. R3 changes to R3 minus 3R2. Okay? So A equivalent to, as there is no change on R1, there is no change on R1, so R1 we will write as it is. And here it is for 0. This operation only for to bring here 0. So 0 we will write. So R2 minus 2 R1. So R2 means 1 minus 2 minus 1 minus minus 2 means 3. 3 minus 4 means minus 1. Here 0, because for this only we are doing this operation. So it is here 0. Then R3, 2 minus minus plus 3 means 5. 4 minus 6 means minus 2. Okay? Now here 0 we have brought here 0. Now here we want 0. It means now here 5 we do not want here. We want here 0. So what will be the operation? Again, first operation we cannot do, we cannot exchange anywhere. If we exchange here, then this 0 will go there and this 5 will go here. So that is not applicable. Okay? Because at the same time 3 will also come here. So this is our first column which we got now what we want, it will get spoiled. So we do not touch to column 1 now. Okay? So here we have to bring 5, we have to do this 5, 0 with the help of this second row only, because first row also we cannot use. If we use first row, this will again change. So first row also we cannot change, because here 0, we can use this R to bring here 0. Understood? So what will be the operation? R3 changes to, now what we want? 5 minus 5. Then we will get 0. But here it is not 5. Here it is not 5. Here it is 3. So we have to first manage that 3 by dividing 3. And then by multiplying 5, we will bring 5. Understood? So what was the operation? R3 minus 5 by 3. Okay? Understood this? First we have to manage this 3. We will do that by dividing 3. And then we have to subtract this 5. From 5, then we will get 0, so multiply by 5. In this way we got this transformation. Now apply A equivalent. Now there is no change on R1 and R2, so write them as they are. Now here it is already 0. For this 0 only we are doing this operation. Now apply on this. Now, what is that? Minus 2 is R3 minus 5 by 3 into R2, that is minus 1. That is minus 2 plus 5 by 3. Okay? That is minus 6 plus 5 means minus 1 by 3. Minus 1 by 3. Okay? Understood? Minus 2. Okay. So in this way, we got from this A, this is upper triangular matrix. This is our required upper triangular matrix. Okay, students? Now here, we have completed this first exercise. In next lecture, we will do the next topic of this chapter. If you like my lecture, then like, share and comment and subscribe my channel, that is my class, and press the bell icon so you will get my next videos notifications. Thank you.